have beauty, right? Everyone stresses that, oh, well, if I plant a tree or have this beautiful garden, then soon the property value will go up and all. But we say we need murals, we need art, we need beauty, but we also need to stay here and enjoy it. And so we clean up our neighborhood and we also fight for our neighbors to stay. Afrotown means community feast. Something that we're super proud of, we have a traditional African-style hob oven, where not only can you pick things from our garden, you can just light up this hob oven whenever you want, and it has a little tube where you can make your own tea, right? But so it means community feast and making sure that all the time we're doing gathering and not just for special events. So I'm gonna fly by a little bit faster. So it's women are the water of the revolution. African indigenous solidarity, being on Africatown is entry chain, and Africatown doesn't negate you chain, it is a part of it, and which is a lonely land, and so in comparison to how America operates and Oakland operates. So Africatown means food justice, plant-based knowledge, and one of the things is Africatown has to mean defending Africatown. And the only ways in which we can defend ourselves is through resistance, ongoing resistance until colonialism is over. People power is how we, you know, continue to resist. Having our accomplices with us so that we can better win. And making sure that we're spiritually sound and that we have ancestral guidance and remembrance. And that includes evoking the ancient art of storytelling and being able to communicate with one another in ancestral forms. And so to conclude, we're also, like, you know, a big emphasis that we're putting on now is being more, very spiritually in tune. It's not just about growing food and feeding each other. It's about knowing where food comes from and knowing how that relates to us, what kind of life that we want to give. Right now, the people in my community are often eating things that are just made of death when it's canned and preserved and spread out the way that it is. And we want people to eat life. We want them to grow it themselves and eat it themselves. And then lastly, so, you know, I was going to wrap up with collective liberation in Palestine, but, you know, I also want people to just learn more about the space and about what kind of collective liberation that we do. We're going to have a party on May 28th because Africatown is being threatened with eviction again and trespassing. And so because we liberate the land for African and indigenous people, that means we have to constantly defend it and protect it. So please come out. It's Saturday, May 28th.